Hello, so this is a follow-up to my FastAPI URL shortener video. This is a demo of it running, and then I'm just going to cover a couple of things that I've fixed since the earlier video. The earlier video is still good, but I just want to kind of add a couple of things. So, most important thing is if you're running from the command line, you need to be running inside the app directory, because that's where all the relevant code is, and you also need to be running this command. So if you don't have reload, when you make changes, they won't necessarily have any impact. So unicorn dash k uvcorn workers uvcorn worker main colon app, which is what I was using before. The p kill is just to kill the process, because if you have it already running, then you get run into issues. So when you run it, you should just end up with something like this. Let's make this bigger. This has been running for a while now, so there's loads of these messages. But yeah, there you can see worker reloading, and that was when I made a change. I modified something in my, here you go, main.py. When I modified it, it reloaded, which was nice. And then that was me testing it with a long URL. So yes, make sure you run that. Also, if you're running it within virtual environment, make sure you run it in the same virtual environment. So yeah, the JSON file, let's just have a look at that. So I've been testing, I've got five examples there. The most recent one I accidentally shortened an already short URL, but that's not a problem. It still just processes it and gives you another five digit alphanumeric suffix. Suffix being the bit after the domain name. Now the domain name would be this bit if you were deploying to a production server, or obviously on the internet. For the purposes of testing, I've just set it as 1, 2, but this can be, you could read this from an any file. Good, so I've already tested it. I've got two Stack Overflow URLs, an odds checker and identity SSO. So let's run it. So I've tidied up the names a bit as well. So now it's just called user cli.py. And there we go. Enter a URL to shorten and press enter. So it doesn't have to be one that you've, it doesn't have, let's just enter URL to shorten. So let's just enter, I'll just enter this one again because it saves me leaving the screen. In fact, that's easier said than done. Let's do this. Paste it in, enter, it's shortened it. So, oh, I've left the print statement there. That's not a problem. But it shows you've short. It shows the JSON dictionary, or, sorry, the Python dictionary where it's shortened, and that's what it's passing to the API. So this bit here is being sent to the API. And what I didn't show in the earlier video actually was I didn't show Swagger bit of it, and also I'll just show. Right. So let's just. Yeah, let's just check the API is reachable. So all of this is accessible from 127 or localhost colon 8000 if you're using the default port, and then docs hash. And there you go. You make a some example request with that in the, and then you get a response. That response there is what is in. Let's just show you, that's in main.py, which is the FastAPI file, and that's what I'm telling it to return there, the check API. Okay, so that there, sorry about that, that there is what you're seeing there. That's the response body. So that's just the test. Collapse that. And then you can see I've changed the create short. I've changed that to post, which is probably the more correct thing to be doing. So if you post in your input URL, the input URL is the long one. And then you can see I've pasted in just then, I pasted in the long URL and it's created me a shortened URL. How did it do that? It called that function. It called the function, which is called gen short URL. Gen short URL is a function which I've got inside my functions file. I've tied that up as well, so it's now just called functions. And what we've got here is gen short URL. So what you just saw there was being created by this function, which is what was being called by the API. Let me show you just a bit more of that. So these lines here are what shorten the URL. And when it runs, if you see here, that's the one that I just ran on line 6. I've got open here the JSON file, which is basically what would be being handled by a database if you were running this on a production server. So this is kind of a MVP, minimum of our product, viable product. So that line 6 corresponds with that. So if I want to enter a short URL, let's do one that we've done before. So that's going to be a massive, really long one. And copy, paste that in. And that's the ZKWTG. And there we go, it's gone off and found the odds checker, that really long odds checker. I don't even know if the link will work. It might redirect because it's probably, yeah, it's a promo. So that is how to run my code, how to use Swagger. This is called, it used to be called Swagger. It's the FastAPI open API test facility. There's also another one, if you've not heard of it, which is the lesser known one called redoc. It's actually nicer in some ways because it's all on one screen, or a bit more all on one screen. So I've not actually used this. Where do we test it? I've not used this, but quite sure. It shows you the endpoint, response samples. Here we go, you have to put in your query parameters there. So yeah, maybe, I don't know. It's there if you want it anyway. REDOC. So yeah, there we go. I've had to kind of zoom this in a bit just to make it a bit more easier to see for the video, but I'm sorry if it's looked a bit congested on the screen, but if you want the code, I'll put a link in the description. And this is a almost complete project for FastAPI to shorten URLs. And all the usuals, from typing, import optional. In the earlier video, I didn't have Pydantic working. I was getting error messages, but I've managed to circumnavigate those. I've created a class called link, where input URL and short URL are optional, but they need to be a string if they're present. I've changed that to post. I don't know, I've accidentally pasted that in. That's not good. There we go. That's the kind of completed project, and hope you've enjoyed watching the development of it. The design, or the kind of the ideas and the formulation of the concept, was in the earlier video, so go check that out. Subscribe if you like these videos. Give me some comments if you've got any other ideas for future projects. Failing that, I may well be... yeah, there we go. There's the squiggles. So VS Code does like to complain, but the thing still works. So I'm not complaining. Thanks for watching. Thumbs up because of the algos. Feel free to comment. Cut all the comments. Any comments are gratefully received. So yeah, see you soon.